Chris Chinnock here, Insight Media, CES 2025. I'm here in the ams Osram booth. We're taking a look at some of their LED devices and applications. So first thing I want to show you is this device right here. This is what they call their Evios HD25. It is basically 25,000 mini LEDs. I guess they're mini LEDs at this point. Maybe micro. It's pretty small. It's a 4:1 aspect ratio. And these are white LEDs. You can see the yellow. Okay, you can put that down. Thank you. And what this is part of the headlight system. You can see that this is coupled into two projectors here. So it's like a high beam and a low beam. And this provides all kinds of versatility in the way you manage the light. This is obviously an alternative to a conventional headlight. But you can see that there's very wide aspect ratios. It can be moved left and right. There's kind of two versions of this thing, which has the full 25,000 LEDs that you can manipulate. Each one of these is addressable. So it's basically a display. There's also one which has a smaller addressable count for lower cost options. And for automobiles that may be limited by communication bandwidth, they may not have the bandwidth to do a $25,000 pixel manipulation. So this can be used to do obviously logos that could be projected on your garage wall or on a building. It can do symbols, and maybe more importantly, safety features for sure. You can look for pedestrians or something that might be crossing in front of you, warning symbols, all kinds of different things you can do with this. One of the features I also like is the ability to tailor blind spots. See that black dot in the bottom there, the black shape? That's moving around to block oncoming headlights to reduce glare. This can also be used to steer the headlights as you go around corners, for example, or even up and down hills a little bit. So pretty cool applications. Yeah, they can steer it back and forth there. So that's nice. Let's move on to the second one. This is a brand new product that Osram's working with this company called Kurtz. It's called Alios. Alios with functional bonding demonstrator. So this company Kurtz basically creates these patterns. They can be a metal pattern. They can be a black pattern with a transparent middle. They can be. This is a kind of a matte metallic pattern here. This is another pattern here with a black cover on top of it. One of the things they highlighted in particular with this one here. Some cockpits want to have a transparent window here. So these are mini LEDs mounted on a transparent flexible foil, which kind of sounds like polyimide. They didn't confirm that, however. But then optically bonded, so this becomes another design feature for folks in the automotive environment. Moving down, this is a proof of concept demonstrator here. It's not going to look too good in the video here for sure. It doesn't look that great here either. But this is based on laser sources, three RGB lasers with a separate MEMS scanner. This little box up here shows the different size, so you could have an LED as in one package to the left, and then as with a TO can down below, can shrink the size, and then you do these little lasers here, these surface mount lasers that are then combined through, I presume, some dichroic prisms into a single beam, which goes to a MEMS scanner, which is not shown. So the point of this demo is this is real wood, and trying to get an LED image through real wood. First of all, you need a lot of luminance. Second of all, the with LEDs, because of the spectral spread, it becomes a very soft image and very little contrast. Lasers with their very narrow spectrum can create a much sharper image here. There is a tons of spec on this that they realize that, so they would have to fix that going forward. But this is actually automotive grade surface mount laser, so which doesn't require a lot of thermal stability either. So that's a kind of interesting option. And finally, over here, they're showing a thing that they call RGBI. So RGB LEDs mounted on an IC driver chip. So the IC itself is 3.7 by 3.1 millimeters, and it has one red, one green, one blue IC LED on it. So the idea of doing this is multiple. For one, you can now daisy chain all of these devices together, which will simplify how you put together the particular lighting option that you want to consider. So for example, if you wanted to do this a design like this, they told me if you wanted to do that on a conventional PCB, it becomes a four-layer PCB. So if you can daisy chain it, you only have to do a one-layer PCB, because it really simplifies the connection for driving it. So there's a system trade-off there. You pay a little bit more for the RGB plus the IC, but you save on some of the integration issues. It is also factory calibrated. Each device is factory calibrated for R, G, and B for a certain white point and luminance. So if you have to replace them, you won't have a mismatch in the display. And it makes it much easier to integrate these things at the tier one or whoever the customer is, because you don't have to do that calibration. It's plug and play, basically. They're also, with this IC, they have a special name for this IC, this standalone integrated driver. So that's the same IC that's used for the LEDs. But it can also drive a certain number of sensors. So you can start to think about integrating various sensors in the design with your LEDs. So the whole, I guess, rationale for putting this together and developing this solution is it becomes a much more of a free-form design tool. You're not stuck with the traditional layouts. You can do all kinds of different things now, and daisy chain them together in a way that really wasn't possible before, or at least was possible, but a little bit more difficultly. So that is pretty much all I know right now. Christian Akbar, Insight Media.